Hello everyone, to yet another episode of Beagle Series, where we try to understand how data is changing different functions and the challenges that come along with it. I'm your host Asmita Mishra from Beagle, a conversational BI platform that brings data to your chat platform. And today with me is a very special guest, Sanjay. He has over 12 years of versatile tech experience from government to corporate projects and has been a mentor to many tech startups. He's special because he's also the CTO at Decision Point and the mastermind behind Beagle. Welcome, Sanjay.
Thanks, Asmita. Thanks for having this interview.
Though I would love to talk Beagle about with you and the amazing response and the feedback that we are coming with, getting from our clients, our early adopters. I mean, I would love to have a detailed conversation on that, on the journey. But today, I would rather like to focus more in terms of how the space that you've worked for so long, that has evolved with data. So first thing first, I would like to, you know, understand, do you feel that there is a need of analysis when, especially when we talk about project management, data analysis?
Let me put it this way. Project management in itself is an important activity when you are delivering projects against a fixed timelines or, you know, adding features to products against a fixed timeline. You would always want to know, you know, how you are faring against these different project timeline and the milestones which you have, right? You need to constantly keep on analyzing the project progress all the times. And to that, you know, you will have to have some hard facts against which you can base your estimates or know exactly where you stand vis-a-vis with a project, right? So, and to do that, there's nothing better than having actual hard data available to you regarding the project milestones, the progress, you know, the allotment of different resources and other things like the issues, bugs, which do come up when we are working on software projects.
That's an interesting point. I mean, if you look at it, it seems to be very straightforward when you talk about project management. But yes, so as you said, it's important as a hard fact to look at data. But what would, how would I say that, what are the challenges does an team manager would face when it comes to data? I mean,
okay, so see, right now there are a lot of tools for project management quite popular across the industry, but even with them, how I would put is that there are like three different problems which you have. One is the, you know, there are these tools which have reports available. Funny thing, in some of them, they are not available by default. You actually have to go and enable them, right? So what you, and even those reports, right? They're not the actually the matrices which you would want to see, right? So what then becomes available to you is the whole project issues log, which is there, and then you keep on going filtering around with or downloading that data into Excel or some way, just try to understand what is going on. Now that is on a single project. Now imagine if you are working on multiple projects simultaneously, or if you are in the leadership, technology leadership, which is responsible for a whole set of projects which are being, you know, which are being worked on or are in a maintenance phase or have small simple CRs coming, right? So it would become very difficult for you to have a overall bird's eye view. But and even if what is available, that is not exactly the way you would want. So the availability of the matrices which you would want to see, that's something which is very important. Then accessibility of the data itself is challenging, right? Now, as I said, there are tools available, but with you have to go look for what you actually want. Mm-hmm. It's not very straightforward in most of these project management tools. That's not their forte, right? And if you are, again, as I said, multiple different projects, you would either have to ask somebody to compile a report for you, or then you are left in dark at times, right? If you have asked for a particular report and you want certain additions to it, then there is a whole long process around it. So nothing is available at a single place for you to really look at. The third thing is the actionability within these tools with respect to all these matrices which you are looking at, right? Even if you find that for a particular module the amount of bugs seem to be very high, there is nothing directly actionable for you other than contacting, if you are in the leadership role, with the project manager, or if you are the project or the engineering lead with the person basically responsible for that particular module. Right. Okay. So to have that actionability from an organization's point of view becomes difficult. Right. So I think these are the challenges which an engineering manager faces when it comes to really looking at the data.
I think I'll hold on to the leadership point that you just mentioned and ask you about how can having real-time access to data with regard to project health can actually bring in more transparency and efficiency in terms of, if I specifically have to talk about resource allocation, budgeting, I mean, do you think that space can be tapped in?
Yeah, as I say, I mean, as leadership at any given moment, there are, tens or hundreds of different projects running. At least for us, it's somewhere around within 50s or 50 such projects running at any given time, right? And it is very difficult for the leadership to be aware of what is going on all the time. I mean, you would have to probably call up the project managers, the engineering leads regularly, although you do have those set up, but I mean, they are weekly at times. You do not have them when you actually want, right? If something is going wrong in a particular project, what you would come to know is only after a week. Now that at times becomes problematic, probably when you had that particular issue. If it became aware to you at that particular moment itself, probably better corrective measures could have been taken, right? And so having this bird's eye view of all of the projects all the time really helps in, you know, resourcing. Also, it gives you a historical data available to you to make better decisions as well, right? To basically resolve your current problems, right? So having real-time data is would be great to have, right? So yep.
That's a very nicely put thought, Sanjay. I think many of the tech leadership hearing this would agree to what you're saying, and would have actually been facing the same challenge that you just mentioned. But now I'll slightly divert with project management to a little more in terms of product, because as in today's time, as it said, every company is a tech company. They happen to work in a different domain. I mean, it's said for a general thing. So somewhere or the other, every company has a function which has some aspect of tech, and they're working something to either supply chain, or whether it's their web product or a tech product, they are involved in it. So for that specific reason, if I say, would it be fair, because the space is evolving, because every now even an FMCG company has a strong tech function with it. So would it be fair to say for developing a new product, especially in case where there is, you don't know, there wasn't any such benchmarking available, a real time analysis on, you know, bugs, resource allocation, I mean, these aspects can be a guiding light in the dark?
Most certainly, right? And it's not just products, but also greenfield projects, right? Something which you are doing for the first time, right? You do not have anything else to really, you know, benchmark against. So how do you go about them, right? There, it is the way you are working on the product, the data which you are collecting with respect to that product, right, in terms of how the issues are being resolved, how new bugs are being handled, what is the life cycle, how many times these bugs are occurring in different places, be it QA, UAT or in production, and what is the, you know, I would call it the quantity of these such bugs, how they are affecting the overall development, right? And these sort of information really helps a product manager as well as an engineering manager, right? Where they start to understand that when such issues are arising and what they need to, how they can prepare beforehand for such things, right? How the complexity of a particular feature is going to result in the amount of bugs which are going to come in. Right? That sort of analysis is right now not available, but if you are able to get that, you can do better resource allocation. A major grouse which engineering leads have is that most of the time the work allocation is not balanced, right? You would have a set of people working quite hard while there would be a set of people who have a relatively simpler task. Now, overall, maybe it turns out that everybody has more or less contributed the same on the project. But at times you realize that you have certain resources idle, right? And having a visibility of the future helps in having a better resource utilization. So, yeah, clear, concise and accessible data is what a project needs to run efficiently. When it is a new project or a product which is being built from scratch.
That's such a nice line to put to sum up the entire thing. I think we've implemented it in our day-to-day activities, and I am sure your team has been well appreciative about it. And I personally have known people who've talked so much good about the fact about the changes that we've done on tracking the real-time things at our end as well.
Yep.
Thank you, Sanjay. Thank you for giving us this time. It was a lovely insight, and as always, I loved talking to you. It's always fun to have a detailed depth discussions with you. Thank you so much, Sanjay, for your time.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, Asmita.